Was it a good idea for airlines to ban smoking?
Yeah, probably was.
Why would you say that?
You know, they stunk up the place.
No, that's not true.
Although I suppose if you looked at it on paper, no, they probably would be doing better financially if they hadn't banned smoking.
No, that's not true neither.
Well, what the f*** do I know? I don't even know who invented a plane. I don't even know why you're talking to me. I have nipples, Steve. Can you milk me? Was it a bad idea?
What? Well, the question is, it was almost certainly a bad idea. It was a lousy idea, in fact, because when smoking was allowed, the cabin air was completely replaced with fresh air every 3 minutes. And now the airlines save money. They save up to 6% of their fuel bills by using a mixture of fresh and recycled air.
And SARS.
Oh. Yeah, using under half the amount of fresh air needed for comfort, increasing the amount of carbon dioxide in the cabin, causing dizziness and nausea and allowing viruses to thrive. Passengers think that because they can't smell smoke, the air is fresher. This is not so. Apart from anything else, it has dramatically increased the number of air rage incidents. One of the earliest reported incidents of air rage involved a passenger in first class, probably trying to take his mind off cigarettes by drinking too much, and he was refused another drink, and so he decided to lodge his displeasure and shat on top of the food trolley. So this is why I was a little sharp with you, Rich, because on a financial level, they've actually made money.
Yeah.
In that sense, you might say if you're a shell, it's a reasonably good idea.
Right.
But it's a bad idea because the health of the passengers suffers enormously as a result of this.
Fire.
So let people smoke, the air gets scrubbed much better, people are in a better mood all round, and everything is
increased. Then your taste buds are shot so you can actually eat shit for food.
You can.
Well, so with all that...